She says the past 18 months have been hell. Last year, Majida Sarwar found a letter from her son Yusuf in which he said he'd gone to do jihad. He was in Syria with a group allied to Al-Qaeda. She told the police, who arrested her son along with his childhood friend, Naheen Ahmed, seen here on the left, when they returned to the UK in January.
And as soon as I found out about the letter, it was middle of the night, and I went straight to the police and I cooperated, and I've done everything I could to help the police, and they used me. I've been betrayed.
Police found these pictures along with traces of explosives and bomb-making instructions. Sarwar and Ahmed admitted preparing for acts of terrorism. Mrs. Sarwar agrees that her son should be punished but believes he was naive and misguided. However, the judge, Michael Topolsky, said they willingly embarked on a course intending to commit acts of terrorism. This was not a spontaneous response to travel to a humanitarian crisis. This was a well-planned operation. The judge praised Mrs. Sarwar but said he couldn't reduce her son's sentence. On the same day, another British jihadist who travelled to Syria, Mashadud Chowdhury, was sent to prison for 4 years.
My son got sentenced 13 years, and that's too harsh. While others, 4 years, 3 years, and one got making bomb, 2 years. Is there a justice in this?
The Home Office has welcomed the sentence, saying it sends out a clear message. A handful of British men have already been jailed for travelling to Syria and Iraq. It's thought many hundreds more are still out there. In a city with a quarter of a million Muslims, the authorities are always urging people to come forward with their concerns about their sons and daughters. Yusuf Sarwar's family say that this sentence will discourage them from doing so. Phil Mackie, BBC News, Birmingham.